select a neural network, there will not be any weights. It doesn't know. It doesn't have any, what I can say, biasing or anything. It doesn't have any sense. So no initial weights. So random weights are there. You have to initialize, and the random weights are fixed. And the how the weights are associated means in this way. You are having the input signals and the weights here, and there will be some output. And here is the target is the T, target T at this point. Okay. So you will give the inputs, and they are multiplied with the weights, and again there will be hidden layer, and they will be multiplied with that, and the same simple mathematical procedure again, these weights, and they will calculate it here, and final output you will get. You will compare with the target. So like that, the target is 10, you achieved 9. What is the error? 1. But percentage of error is 10%. So based upon this error, I have to adjust my weights. This is what the back propagated. So weights are back propagated with the error. This particular algorithm is known as back propagated neural network or back propagation neural network. These weights are back propagated in order to have the exact weights. How can we tell the weights are exact or accurate? Only the thing is, when they reach the exact target, then that particular weights are perfect weights or exact weights. Till now you have to repeat this process. Till now you have till that process you have to train your neural network. That is the situation. Like that, your number of inputs, you can't change the number of inputs. The number of inputs is always that number of inputs only. So target is fixed. In between you have to adjust your weights. And what is this hidden layer? I already mentioned the hidden layer. You are having the activation function. What is the purpose of activation function also? I mentioned activation function, you have the sigmoidal function or whatever. See, if the problem is too complex, okay, if the problem is too complex, then more number of hidden layers in order to address the complexity of the problem. Simple thing. If it is highly complex problem, means highly non-linear problem, okay, the mathematical words. If it is a highly non-linear problem, means the order is more than 2, more than 3, then more number of hidden layers. Only single layer means simple neural network, 1-to-1 input and output, simple single order. Okay, it will not address the complex issues. If the issue is very complicated or highly complicated, you have to adjust your neural network in such a way that more number of neural networks, higher order. Why it is a higher order? Because your problem itself is more complex. Simple tools cannot adjust, simple mathematical models cannot address the issue, cannot address or cannot solve your problem. So that is the reason why your neural network architecture is purely depends upon the problem that you have selected. Okay, it is purely depends upon the problem that you have selected. If it is highly non-linear or highly complex problem, means your neural network design should be in such a way that, okay, afterwards again you have to test, and your what is the activation function, simple activation function is, and again I mentioned, it is a forecasting application, one particular activation function. If it is another problem, one particular activation function. So if I keep on discussing about activation function, it will take more time. But the simple thing, it is a non-linear function. Your sigmoidal function is like 1/(1+e^2-x). It is a highly non-linear function. It can address some of the issues like that linear problem. So another function. So like that, you can fix some of the input layers, and you can fix some of the hidden layers. And one more thing, actually there is no particular rule that how many input layers you are taking, how many hidden layers you are taking, and output layer maybe 1 or 2. But there is one nominal rule. What I can say is that particular rule is, actually it is not verified or tested, empirical relation. Empirical relation means based upon trials, just only there is no mathematical proof. Based upon empirical more number of trials, that is only an estimation. Generally, input layer to hidden layer, there is 1.5 times your hidden layers from the input layer. So that is the reason why in my problem, so before that I have done so many investigations. So many days, even weeks, almost like 1 month I have took in order to finalize this neural network. So 30 inputs and 45 hidden and one output layer. I'm not stressing that if you go in this direction, you will get this result. You can, based upon your problem, you can, based upon the same problem also, you can design another neural network with the best performance. Okay, that is based upon your design, and afterwards you have to keep on trying the best trials that you can get it. So like that, I can take 30-45 number of training patterns, even it is not fixed, 80. So with that I can saturate and I can get some better results. As per my knowledge, I can fix it. And what is the momentum factor? Momentum factor is, if you go to the load flow studies in everywhere, some all find it. Momentum factor is that you have to make the fast. Okay, you have to make it fast. So that is the reason why we are fixing as a momentum factor in order to fast up the things. The convergence process should be fast enough. So that is the reason why I'm fixing some momentum factors. Learning rate. What do you mean by learning rate is a data? Another factor. So you are training. You are giving the training to the system, but how far it is receiving and how far it is executing. So that is nothing but learning rate. Another parameter that you are fixing. So learning rate, it is a point. Anyhow, it is also, so based upon number of trials, initially I have fixed some momentum factor, some learning rate. But in the literature, it is available that so momentum factor some 0.2 to 0.5. So learning rate is from 0.5 to 0.1. It is reliable or feasible. So in my problem, I tested. So finally, I fixed my convergence criteria. It is. So what is the training process? So training process is the first 30 wind samples I have taken, fixed, and the 31st is the target. Again, next 32 to 61, I went and the 62 samples. So like that, rigorously, I went to the next 80 patterns. So 30 into 80 is 2,400 patterns. After the problem is converges, the converged weights are used to test the speed data. Here I am specifying you. What do you mean by the convergence is? It is up to you. Okay. The target is 10. The target is 100. Okay. If I get 90, if it is fine for me, I can fix the 90 is also fine with the error is fine and the problem is converged. I am not satisfied. Target is 100. I have to get 99 means I'll fix the error rate is only 1%. So that is only the tolerance. So like that, I have to fix some limit. So fix what is the target until what point I can reach? What is the tolerable limit? Based upon that, I can say the convergence. Once the convergence is done, what we have to do? We are fixing the weights. I already mentioned in the beginning of my lecture that the weights are randomly fixed. Okay. But after a series of trials at one particular weights, I'm reaching the target more or less. The convergence reached, that particular weights are saved because it is everything is programming based, MATLAB programming based. That particular weights are saved in the file and that particular weights are used for testing. So next time whenever you want to test with that, the weights are fixed. The initial stage I can say that I don't have any weights, but after that these weights are fixed. Okay, always if I want to test the system, these are the particular weights from the input to hidden, these are the particular weights from the hidden to output, that I have to fix like that. So these are the, like that, this recursive procedure is used for the next 24 samples. So next 24 hour sample data I have to get. Why I'm telling it is a 24 samples data, I mean, this is my application is for day ahead market. The day ahead market means next 24 hour samples. So in the graphic, just I will explain. The first samples are 24812, 25110 in the testing. Already training has been done for the 18 to 30. 2400 samples. After that, next 80 is over. 2480. Next one is 24812, 25110. Next the output is 2511. This process is repeated for next 24. So 2481, okay, 2480 plus 24 is 2504. So 2481 to 2504 is next 24 samples. Next 2511 to 2534, 24 samples. This is the way to forecast the next 24 hours sample. So our sample is, I am considering 1 year wind data. 1 year wind data, every hour is my sample. Like that, 365 into 24 is 8760. Like that, I am considering total 8760 wind samples. 1 year wind samples. In that one particular 2400 samples, because 30 inputs, 80 training patterns were used for the training. After that, the next samples is for the testing. 2400 plus, after that, every sample, one gap is there. Like that, 80 training patterns, 80 gap is there. After that, I am going for the testing from 2008 to 2005-10. So after that, the testing is from 2005-11 to 2005-34. This is my testing. So after that, what we have to do, whether I am getting accurately forecasting or not, and how can I estimate? So like that, I am calculating the absolute percentage error at each and every case. So for 24 hour samples, so like that, some 8% error, 20% error, one case like that I am getting. So average error is like 13% also. So another statistical parameters also I am calculating, because I want to justify my answer. Means only one statistical parameter is not sufficient to evaluate my forecasting efficacy or forecasting efficiency. So that is the reason I am going for mean absolute error, mean absolute percentage error, root mean square error. Even I went to even correlation quotient. What do you mean by correlation quotient? Means actual value is there, forecasted value is there. So if the correlation quotient is 1, means actual value, forecasted value, 100% accurate. So but in my case, the forecasting value is some 0.904, means 90% accurate, like that. So this is about the actual value. This is the color indicating. So forecasted value in the red. So somewhere I mentioned some 20% or more deviation. Sometimes the deviation is almost so like that, the 24 samples. So I feel even that error is average error. If I go around 10 plus, more than 10%, I do not feel more than 10% error is good. Then I went to the next forecasting, the state estimation based neural network. What do you mean by the state estimation based neural network? This is same. It is also using your back propagation neural network. Okay. So based upon the target, we have to fix it up. Same neural networks training. But initially, the weights are not fixed, the random weights are there, and we are finally fixing the weights based upon your back propagation algorithm. But here in the neural networks training, the back propagation algorithm I am not using, the state estimation based algorithm I am using. The state estimation based algorithm, based upon the minimization of sum of squares of weighted deviation, the perfect weights I will fix at 1 inch. But in the first case, in the back propagation based neural network, the weights are not fixed at 1 instant. They keep on training, more number of training, till the problem convergence. Once the problem converges, we fix the weights. But here, it is non-iterative approach. Okay, it is a non-iterative approach. We'll go to the mathematical procedure. We will estimate the weights with the sum of squares of the weighted deviation. Simple thing. What do you mean by the sum of squares of the weighted deviation? Sum of squares of the weighted deviation means the deviation is high from the actual value to the targeted value. We have to reduce it. For that, why we have to take the sum of squares of the weighted deviation? Because sometimes the error is higher, error is low. That means negative error or positive error. The average, it may become zero. So that is the reason why always we go to the square of the error. So that is the best procedure. So we have to minimize the sum of the squares of the weighted deviation. In such context, I'll fix that weights from input to hidden and hidden to output. Okay, like back propagation neural network, it is non-iterative approach, but in the back propagation it is iterative approach. Same network we are taking, but it is a simple neural network, actual value and the forecasted value. So this difference, okay, this difference square and the sigma is a weight associated to it. Based upon that, we have to minimize it. Okay, we have to minimize the error based upon such mathematical procedure. So this is state estimation based approach. So if I keep on explaining, it will take more than 1 hour, even the state estimation based approach. But in a simple sentence, I can tell, in the state estimation based approach, the raw data I can give. The raw data means definitely there may be some error. Raw data means there may be error, right? It will not be purified data. So that raw data I'll take and I will simplify by using the weighted least square estimation. Weighted least square estimation means WLSE. Weighted least square estimation means the deviations are reduced. The errors or the deviations are reduced as minimum as possible based upon the estimate. And finally, we will estimate the weights. Okay. Weights between input to W is the one weight and A is the another weight. If you see, the B is the another weight and W is the another weight. This V and W are the estimated. Here from this matrix, the V can be estimated if you investigating the input to hidden. So like here, the V is estimated by the Gaussian elimination. And the next one is a similar way. If you proceed, the W is estimated. So from here, the inverse of it, you can estimate the W. The same neural network, the same testing procedure, but only thing is the weights are estimated in the mathematical way. So some accuracy has been improved. Simple thing. The random way you are proceeding, but you are going in the systematic way. In which way you will get the better results? Definitely in the systematic way. The initial, the back propagation neural network, the random way, randomly initialized and the estimated, the weights are. Okay. But in the state estimation way, and one particular mathematical procedure is based upon the sum of squares of the weighted deviations are minimized. So based upon that, we will proceed. The deviations or the errors are minimized based upon that the weights are fixed in that particular way. We forecasted for the same next 24 samples. So errors are like that, even 2%, 5%, 7%, 14%, like that the average error is reduced to 8.173%. Okay, there the average error is some around 13.1%. So error is reduced. You can see that some of the peaks are reduced, except at one or two places. Most of the times you are forecasting and actually you are almost like coinciding. So similar to that, so here I am estimating, so backpropagation neural network at every instant and state estimation based neural network. In the majority of the cases, your state estimation based neural network is the best. Okay, like that if you make the average is 13.2 and the average is some 8.1. This is a comparison. So here if I use the backpropagation, state estimation and actual, where your state estimation is actually coinciding with the actual values rather than your backpropagation neural network. So this is all estimations. Even your mean absolute error is best in case of here, and your root mean square error is best in the correlation factor 0.90 here and 0.90% in the previous case. Okay, 90% in the previous case. And charge. Sorry, maybe charging problem. So 90% in the previous case and 93% in the present case. It has been improved. And even execution time is also improved. What is the reason? Actually, previously it is a iterative approach. Number of times you have to perform and you have to get the result in order to fix the weights. But it is a non-iterative approach. In the first instant, you can fix your weights. So non-iterative approach, the execution time also considerably reduced. You don't see how many seconds it has been reduced. You can see the percentage of reduction. 38 seconds to 68 seconds to 34 seconds itself is almost like half of the reduction, but is more than that. Okay, so summary, in this case summary only, still we are going to discuss one more neural network. Okay, we are going to discuss even one more neural network. Even it is 5, I can continue for another 15 minutes. So the summary for these two, the problem with the backpropagation neural network, it can have the problem of local minima problem, okay? But it is not there with the state estimation based neural network. It is completely mathematical approach. Weights are estimated between layers, accurate enough because using the weighted least square approach, and it is a non-iterative approach. This is a summary till this point. Next, still staying with the neural network, I want to go for the better one. Then I am using wavelets. The neural networks associated with the wavelets can give the best result. Can use the best result. The reason is the wavelets, they can fix based upon the problem, because the wavelets structure is, in the wavelets you have the translation and the dilation parameters. They are nothing but sir. May I continue, sir? Hello?
It is some other disturbance, sir. You can continue.
Okay, thank you. So, wavelets in translation and dilation parameters. So, like your A and B. So, this is nothing but you are fixing like the length and breadth of the wavelet. So, like the length and breadth of the wavelet based upon the translation and dilation parameters, they are arbitrarily varying, and based upon the problem, they will fix. So what is that? What is the difference between the artificial neural network, state estimation based neural network,
All participants, please switch off your radios. Participants, please switch off your radios.
Okay. Based upon natural artificial neural network, state estimation based neural network to the a wavelet based neural network is, here the activation function is your wavelets. There are some sigmoidal function or a tan hyperbole based upon the problem, but here your Mexican hat wavelet or Morlet wavelet, those things, the same neural network I am using. Why everywhere I am using the same neural network? If I want to go for the comparison, same architecture I have to use and I can compare. The different schemes I have to use means the comparison is not justified. So that is the reason why same architecture I am using in each and every case, and how the results that I am using. So in the hidden layer, okay, the JET1 is a more wavelet based or Mexican hat wavelet based neural network. Okay, so The main advantage with this neural network is, wavelet-based neural network is, it has undergone to the multi-resolution analysis. That is the main advantage. Only here I will stress, the remaining part just I will go like that. Why? Because the multi-resolution analysis is the key point in order to understand the wavelet. What do you mean by multi-resolution analysis? A simple example I will give. So, one student came to me and he told that, sir, I lost my notes. Okay, I lost my assignment notes in the college. College means where? You have five buildings in the college. Which building? Block number four. The block number four, where it is? The room number, floor two. The floor two, the room number five. Room number five. So I sit in the bench three. Bench three and row number one. Like that, you have the five categories. Okay. The first one is, he went to the kids' college. In the kids' college, of the five buildings, one particular building number four, the building number floor, the floor number two, the floor number two, room number three, the room number three, row number one, the row number one, again, column number four. If I can tell in that particular way, he can directly go and get his notes back, for example, if he missed it. So, multi-resolution analysis means there is a problem, there is a flaw, okay, there is a mistake. If you want to identify the mistake, if you can categorize perfectly, you can easily identify that mistake. So similar to that, you can go to the multi-resolution. So for example, n levels decomposition I am doing. So actual coefficient and detailed coefficients. Actual coefficient, detailed coefficients, each and every. Okay. So one is low frequency signal and one is high frequency. Now, what do you mean by low frequency signal or high frequency signal means? For example, in my wind case, for example, low frequency or low repeatable or high frequency or high repeatable. I can separate them. That second level, third level, like that, all the wind samples are decomposed perfectly and they are able to forecast, means my data is accurate enough. Okay, just like that, forecasting, the simple way of forecasting or traditional way of forecasting, rather than that, it can decompose level to level. Okay, if I can able to decompose level to level, higher frequency level to the lower frequency level, if you have the signal means. So you just see here, if you have the signal means, so each and every, if you decompose in a particular manner means, the forecasting, it is very simple. So what you will do in the wavelet based neural network, first you decompose the signal and each and every signal you can forecast, and afterwards you can add them. Okay, wavelet method based time series analysis available in the matter, based upon that you can able to do it, WMTSA. So like that, each and every level decomposition, it may be 7 level decomposition, 8 level decomposition or 9 level decomposition. How it depends, the number of decomposition levels, the number of decomposition levels, the number of decomposition levels depends upon how many number of samples that you have. If you consider only 1000 samples, 1000 by 2 to the power of 5, you get 32 number of samples available. That should be greater than a particular ratio. The condition is there in the wavelet. So like if you have 1000 samples, maybe 5 level decomposition is enough. That is not exact rule, but okay, mathematical analysis. Maybe if you go to 6 level decomposition, you can do the best one. So like that, number of decomposition levels depends upon the available data samples, available training data samples. So that is another thing, the same training algorithm, but before that, you have to go for the multi-resolution analysis is carried out on wind speed. And each decomposed signal is forecasting using AWNN individually. Later, the standard backpropagation gradient descent algorithm, same error estimation method. And we have to minimize the error. This is the way to proceed. And every time we have to differentiate the values, the mathematical functions, and we have to get the values, the same algorithm and same mathematical procedures that we have to. Once the weight converges, once the problem converges, the same thing, the same weights are fixed. Apart from the weights, the translation and dilation parameters. Again, I am mentioning, the beginning of wavelets, I mentioned that the translation and dilation parameters are not fixed. Okay, the translation and the dilation parameters are not fixed. They will adjust according to the problem. Okay, and the advantage, another advantage with the wavelet is that it can perform the time varying frequency analysis. If you go to the Fourier analysis also, it can do, okay, can do either time varying, one of the things can perform frequency varying signals. But The time-varying signals, time-varying frequency analysis signals can also be analyzed by using wavelets. Your wind is nothing but time-varying frequency analysis. The time is varying, as the time moves, the frequency, because they are uncertain, the frequency also varies. So this time-varying frequency signals can be analyzed more effectively and efficiently by using the wavelet analysis. In the wavelet analysis also, we have the Mexican hat wavelet, and we have the Morlet wavelet, other one. Okay, so with the different studies in that 7-level decomposition, 8-level decomposition, 9-level decomposition, the one way, so where we are using the wavelets as the activation function. Once I have used the activation function as a Mexican hat wavelet, the name Mexican hat wavelet is, the symbol is like hat. Okay, so another name is the Morlet wavelet. So like the different activation functions I have used, and I am using for the best results. The same, the analysis, same, I'm using the best results means, the best forecasting technique means, how can I analyze? I can analyze by using the same statistical parameters such as absolute percentage error, mean absolute error, mean absolute percentage error, root mean square error, and correlation coefficient. And finally, so Mexican hat wavelet, 7-level decomposition, this is the error, 8-level, this is the error, 9-level, this is the error. If I go for the Morlet, this is the error. So finally, I am fixing that a particular Morlet wavelet is selected, and if I go to the particular level of decomposition, 8-level, I am getting the better results in correlation factor is 94.3% accurate. Okay, the correlation coefficient is another statistical parameters. The forecasting analysis, it can give you 0.94, is 94.3% accurate in the Morlet wavelet. So finally, I fixed that based upon so many artificial neural network analysis in that traditional. So I know that the backpropagation neural network, I may not get the better result, but it is the benchmark one and traditional method of forecasting. First, I have to done. If I want to go to the next level or the next one, first I have to go to the traditional one. First, I have to get familiar with the traditional neural network. First, I have to analyze that algorithm. I have to get the code. Okay, I have to analyze that code, and I have to get the code with that. I have to get the result that has one set of the result. So next one, I can improvise with the state estimation based on neural network, and I can change the activation function remaining activation functions, your sigma idle function, everything is fixed. So mathematically, 1/1 plus e to the power of -6 is, they are fixed until and unless your x input is changed. But your neural wavelet based neural network, they are not fixed. Okay, they change according to the translation and dilation parameters. But the translation and dilation parameters will change according to the problem. So that is the more advantage. That is a more advantage with respect to the wavelet-based, okay, wavelet-based neural network. So that is. So this is about even comparison with the BPNN, SENN, and Morlet 8-level. Because here I am concluding in the wavelets, this is the best. Finally, I am comparing it. This is the best result. 6.9%, less than 7%. So initially 13% to 8% to 6.9%, I am reducing. This is about the summary. The summary means the Morlet wavelets are the best suitable for analyzing sudden variation. See why? Because the time varying, they can able to suit for the time varying frequency analysis. The time varying frequency analysis. Okay, your wind signal is highly chaotic in nature, highly changeable with respect to time. So that is the reason why Morlet wavelets are suitable.
వెంటనే పడుకుంటున్నారు, తినేసి పొద్దున్న లేవడానికి బతకం, ఎక్సర్సైజ్ చేయలేదు, మొత్తం డైలీ రొటీన్ అంతా డిసిప్లిన్. ఇది కరెక్ట్ కాదు. మన శాస్త్రాల్లో ఏం చెప్పారు, ఆయుర్వేదంలోను నేచురోపతిలోను, ఏకభుక్తే మహాయోగి, ద్విభుక్తే మహాభోగి, త్రిభుక్తే మహారోగి అన్నారు. ఒక పూట తినేవాడు వండిన పదార్థం. నేను ఇక్కడ మీల్ అనేది లేదు, బ్రేక్ఫాస్ట్ అనేది మనం పెట్టుకున్న పేర్లేదు.
Okay, so in the conclusion, so finally I want to tell you, I have done this forecasting studies with the different type of neural network, but finally I can able to get the better results with the Morlet 8-level. This is only the wind speed forecasting. Then how can you apply it for wind power forecasting? The wind power forecasting is nothing but your wind power forecasting is nothing but afro AVQ. You're selecting a particular location, your wind density is fixed, that particular location, for a particular wind turbine, that area of cross section is fixed. Only the variable thing is your wind speed. If you can able to estimate the wind speed with a simple, again, MATLAB programming, remaining parameters is fixed, whatever the available wind power, with that you can forecast your wind power. You have the better wind power forecasting method, that it is better for you because you can give the schedule a day before because it is a day ahead market. So this is about my presentation and thank you all. And if you have any questions, please tell me. So some of you leaving in the chat box, your issue is regarding, your doubt is regarding wavelet decomposition. In that may I know what is your doubt in the wavelet decomposition? Till what levels we have to go or how it has been done? Time series. I'm not waiting.
Participant, unmute yourself and express your doubt.
Okay. So like that you can give this. So another 5 or 6 questions I can answer in 10 to 15 minutes. Please, yeah. Any of you, please you can tell. Madam.
Sir, my question is, as you have discussed about the wavelet decomposition that you have used model at up to 8 level, in multi-resolution analysis, we usually go frequency decomposition. So we
time-varying frequency analysis. Simultaneously, both the things can be analyzed. That is the advantage.
If we have a data which varies with the frequency or the time, we know what particular frequency we need. For example, in multi-resolution frequency, if you have taken the x value as some 100 hertz, when you are decomposing it to approximate detail, so for each and every approximate detail coefficient, we are mentioning some amount of some range of frequency. So I want to know, when you are doing the time series decomposition, how we could analyze that approximation and detail coefficients over there?
Okay, madam. Actually, so you are asking your question related to maybe even digital imaging processor related issues and everything also.
Yeah.
Context also you are asking, it seems.
Yeah.
But actually, I am very particular to my problem, madam. I am very particular to domain. In my domain, actually, how I have done this wavelet-based analysis, only every program, everything, I have fixed like the backpropagation algorithm. But only thing is, the hidden layer, I have used this Mexican hat wavelet and Morley-based wavelet function, wavelet-based neural network. So rest of the things, I am not thinking of. Only based upon my error, based upon my target, automatically my translation and dilation parameters are adjusted. Regarding coming to the decomposition, eventually I am using MODWT, maximum overlap discrete wavelet transform. And the DWTSA, discrete wavelet time series analysis. These are the two tools we have to install in our MATLAB.
Yeah.
So based upon that, we code automatically based upon problem, the decomposition has been done. After every decomposed signal has been forecasted and they will be summarized automatically, it has been done. Only with our program we will do normally like backpropagation algorithm, but only I am using wavelet neural network as my activation. If I can able to install these two things, if I go to the rest of the program, the decomposition has been done automatically and the forecasting has been done automatically prior to my backpropagation algorithm. But only the thing is decomposition. Regarding the decomposition, I'm already regarding the frequency, how much frequency that I can, I do not know exactly. But the thing is, I went to the different levels of decomposition, 7, 8, and 9. Why only 7, 8, 9? Still less than levels, I do not want to go. Why? Because my number of samples are fixed. Based upon that, minimum number is 7 that I know. After 7, I go to 8 and 9. I went on for 10. But by that, parameters are saturated. I have checked for the forecasting. Where I got the exact results only, I identified. Based upon that, I went. So, exactly regarding the frequency, how it is analyzed, I don't know. Because purely, I am going to the forecasting of the wind signal. the frequency analysis I am not that is inside it is doing, but that exact analysis I don't know.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Next.
Hello, sir.
Madam, please tell.
Sir, this is Divya from St. Peter's Engineering College.
Good evening, madam, sir. Please tell. Okay.
I have two questions, sir. My first question is that in a wind turbine,
okay,
for a subsynchronous resonance, if there occurs a subsynchronous resonance, then how,
okay,
which type of converter, which type of power electronic converter we can use,
okay,
at the grid side?
Okay, next. What is your
the
next question?
Is, for a variable speed wind turbine, we are,
okay,
using in general the doubly fed induction generator currently, sir. But
okay,
is there any recent trends in the generator system?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's it.
Not last. I have not listened, ma'am, properly. Doubly fed induction generator. But you are asking any recent generator is there other than that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Coming to your first question, if it is a subsynchronous resonance, what type of a converter? First of all, I am from purely power system background, ma'am. Actually, I have even done the simulation studies in my PhD, the stability issues studies I have done. I worked with the synchronous squirrel cage induction generator, doubly fitted induction generator, permanently managed synchronous generator. But everywhere the modeling and everywhere all the pretty simulated model I have taken directly because I do not know about the converter. Because if you go to the DFIG, there will be GSC and RSC, rotor side control, grid side converter is there. That mechanism only I have gone through. But inside the converter, how it has been acting, I don't know, because I am from power system background. And the next thing, what selection have to made exactly regarding that issue, I don't know exactly for subsynchronous. But majority of the people are using doubly fitted induction generator. But actually, we are having PMSG, permanent packet synchronous generator, is also equally good as doubly fitted induction generator. But the problem is, you have the saturation problem of the magnet. You are using the natural magnet. That is one of the issue. And the cost is another issue. Because of these two reasons, in majority of the cases, we are using DFIG. But coming to SCIG, but SCIG is having so much inferior when compared to DFIG. So because dynamic compensation is not there. There is only fixed capacitor. So fixed compensation, which is not possible. Again, you have to go for the static wires or the fax devices for the compensation. So that is the reason why we are going to two things, DFIG, doubly fitted induction generator and permanent magnet synchronous generator. But coming to the converters, what converters are suitable means, actually, I do not know because I am purely from power system background.
Okay,
ma'am.
Okay.
Next.
Thank you, sir. I want to say one thing, sir. Finally, I want to express my heartfelt thanks to you. Why? Because you enlightened this webinar with a very fruitful result, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. Even I must thank to Princeton College management and head of the department and all of you.
The AAA department only.
Okay, ma'am. That's why I'm expressing my
management also, sir, for giving us this wonderful opportunity to organize this type of events.
Even I am expressing my sincere gratitude to Princeton College management and head of the department and all colleagues. Because of you only, I got this an opportunity and I'm exploring myself. Next, any question? With one or two questions, we can close. Anybody else?
Hello, sir.
Sir, please, Krant Kiran, sir, tell me.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir, a small doubt. What is the difference between artificial intelligence techniques, soft computing techniques, meta-heuristic techniques, evolutionary techniques? What is the difference?
Okay.
The same is being used in most of the cases. What is the difference between among these four?
Okay, sir. Even I am not that much familiar, but according to my knowledge, I'll clarify you. So actually, artificial neural network means, I already mentioned, in the artificial neural network only, we are having all these. The knowledge-based system, or particle sham
optimization.
Artificial
intelligence techniques.
Yeah, in the artificial intelligence technique only, we are having this artificial neural network. Soft computing,
yes,
your soft computing based system is like your programming based, all your programming based. And meta-heuristic technique means, this meta-heuristic technique means, already evolutionary algorithm based they will come. So even I don't have exact clarity, but they are categorized whether they are natural evaluation based technique or mathematically based technique or biologically inspired technique. Based upon that, they are categorized. Sir. So exact pure difference, I don't know exactly.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Next, any another two questions? We can know another one or two questions. So participants, anybody? Anybody for another one or two questions? So before closing the session, just one thing I want to tell you. Actually, I have seen Brahmaya sir here. So Brahmaya sir was my HOD during 2004 to 2006 till my second year actually. So when I was in third year, sir left to VNR Vigyan Jyoti. I was a student of VNR Vigyan Jyoti during 2004 to 8. Beginning when I was seen, I want to tell, but actually end of the session, I want to tell you, he was my HOD. Sir, actually even taught even transformers for my batch, I think, in 2.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I am here. Yes, sir. I recognize you, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I recognize you.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Majority of the times I use it to approach you during the counseling.
Okay, sir. Sharing can be removed. Sharing can be stopped.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. I removed the sharing.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. I think still, if any one or two doubts, we can allow the participants. Otherwise, we can close. Any participants are willing to ask any doubts, you can ask. Otherwise, we can conclude session, sir.
Sir, you have given very good information, sir.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. Sir, Brahmaya sir is also working in the same institute?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay, sir, shall I close us for any?
We can go for a vote of thanks, sir. Now it is okay. Time for vote of thanks. Thank you all participants for participating in this WFDP. And thank you, Rakesh sir. In spite of your busy schedule and your college works, you have spared time for our FDP and given us a valuable webinar on overview of artificial intelligence techniques, ANN basics, characteristics of ANN, learning methods, back propagation algorithm, and its practical application, state estimation techniques, comparison between back propagation and state estimation technique. And also, I have very excellently explained about wavelet-based neural networks, which is very, very useful for all research scholars and those who are doing PhD and those who are completed and those who want to do research in this area. Thank you very much, sir, for your webinar. Thank you very much, sir.
So, before closing that, I want to tell you one thing, sir. Actually, today we are organizing one workshop from June 1. 1 to 5, I was a coordinator, co-coordinator. So due to that reason, I said come a bit late. Actually, June 1st to 5th, we are organizing a workshop. So that is reason why. But actually, I prioritized this workshop as I given you word priorly. But actually, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. And thank you one and all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Now we will end the session, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
We will end the session now, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.